Hi guys, welcome back to another video. This is Codeforces Round 873 and we'll see the first problem, that is divisible array. So I'm pretty sure that like many of you might have solved it, but let's take this as an opportunity to see multiple solutions on how we can solve this. So in this video, I'll suggest two solutions. I'll try to explain two solutions. One is done by me and one is actually written by some of other coders. So let's quickly jump into the problem. The problem states that you will be given an integer n and you need to find an array a1, a2 up till an. Okay, you need to generate an array and they are calling this array as a perfect array. So what is the meaning of a perfect array? Means it should follow three rules. These three rules are: all the elements of the array should be of the form of it should be less than or equal to 1000, it should be in the range of 1 to 1000, and every number should be divisible by its index. If you have an ai, I is the index, means ai mod I should be 0. That's the second point. And third point is, if you take the sum of all the numbers, it should be divisible by n. They will give you an n that it should be divisible. So for example, let's try to see this with a solution. So here, as you see, for 1 we can skip it, for 2 n, right, 2. So 2 you can write it as 2 and 4, because 2 mod, what is the index here? 1. 2 mod 1 is 0 and 4 mod 2 is also 0. 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 mod 2, that is 6 mod 2 is also 0. So 2, 4 is a valid solution. Now for 3, 1, 2, 3. So let's write this out, right? So it is 1, 2, 3. N value is 3. So they told the result is 3 and index will be of the format of 1, 2, 3. So 1 mod 1 is 0. That is second point, okay? First point is already satisfied. Second point is also satisfied. 2 mod 2 is 0. 3 mod 3 is 0. Now the sum of all the elements should be divisible by this n. What is 3, 4, 5, 6? 6 mod 3 is also 0. So this is a valid array. So we can generate any array. If there are multiple solutions also, we can do it. So now let's try to figure out pattern, like how this number can be found. If you see, there is a very evident solution here, right? What is happening? If the index is same as the number, if the index is same as the number, then it is very well a can be the same. I can simply write 1 1 2 2 3 3, right? If it's 4 1 2 3 4 5. But this is one observation, but we need to check for other solutions. Let's check for something like 5. Okay, randomly I'm taking, like, okay, if they gave n value as 5, I'll generate the array as 1 2 3 4 5. And what is the index I can get? Index is 1 2 3 4 5. Now everything is divisible by its index. Now take the sum. Sum is how much? N into n plus 1 by 2. 5 into 6 by 2 is 15, right? 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1 is 15. And 15 is modulus n. N is what? 5 equal to 0. Okay, so this is also working. Now let's take for a smaller number to see whether the number works or not. So let's take n equal to 2. In test case, they gave us 2, 4. But let's take 1, 2 here. What is the index? Index is 1, 2. This is satisfied, less than 1000. What is this? 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 mod 2 is not equal to 0. So there is some flaw with our algorithm. But one thing that is pretty sure is we are able to change any number, right? So there can be a standardization. What can we standardize it? All the numbers can be indexed. But can I say that there is one carryover here? That is, what is 3 mod 2? 3 mod 2 is 1. So this one, if I add it somewhere here such that it satisfies the condition, then it will be a valid number, right? So let's try for one more solution and then come back to this, because this is small, we won't be able to generalize it, right? So let's try for n equal to 6. Maybe 6, I can do like 1 2 3 4 5 6. I'll generate this number. And what is the index? Index is 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. Everything is same, but what is the sum here? N into n plus 1 by 2, that is 6 to 1 you get, right? 6 into 7 by 2 is 21, right? And 21 mod 6 is also not equal to 0. So this condition is flawed. But what I can say, what I told is, what does it mean? 21 mod 6 means it is not divisible. It means that from the lowest value, from the lowest multiple of 6, from the closest multiple of 6 is minus 3, right? 21 mod 6 is 3. That means 18 is the closest multiple. That is, 21 minus 3 is the closest multiple you can get with 6. So can I make the sum as 18? It's not possible, right? Because this is already the best value. I can't make it as 18, but I can add some number to it. That is, from 18, 21 is there. I can make it as 24. 24 is also 6 multiple. So how do I get 24? So let's understand this. So minus 3 means it will be 18, but plus 3 means it will be 24. In order to get from 18 to 24, what do we do? So that is 21 mod 6 will give you 3. We'll subtract 6 from it. So what is this? Which will be 6 minus 3 will be 3. So from 21, I am going to a 3. Then from the entire 6, I am subtracting 3 here so that I get the next number as 24. So for example, if I take something like 23, right? 23 mod 6 is what? 23 mod 6 will be 5, right? It is 5. Now, what will be the closest number? I simply can put 6 minus 5. 6 minus 1, 5 will be 1. So what do I do? It is 23 plus this remainder. So you get 24. Now, the remainder is 3. If I add 3 to this value anywhere here, you get 24. Where can I add? I can add here also, right? 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 mod 6 is not equal to 0, so I can't add here. I'll go here. 8 mod 5, no. But 6 mod 3 is also possible. But you can't actually generalize it, right? You have to check for each of the number. But there is one magical number here. What is that? 1. If you put any number here, it will be satisfied, right? If I put 1 plus 3 or 1 plus 7, anything, it will be satisfied. So what happened here? I made this as 4. So 4 mod 1 is 0, everything is 0. Now sum everything. 4 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 will be 24. And the whole number will also be divisible by 6. Now let's go back to our n equal to 2. So where is n equal to 2? We got 1, right? 1 means what? So from the closest multiple 2, it is 3. And if I add one more, that is 2 minus 1 is 1. That means if I add 1 from 3, I get to 4. So I add 1 here, so it will be 2 plus 2. 2 plus 2 will be 4. 4 mod 2 equal to 0. Now let's see how did we code. So this is the solution here. If you want, it's an accepted solution. I'll link it in the description. So how did we code it? I just took the sum of n numbers here. Then I want to know what is the closest multiple of n. I'm just generalizing everything. What is the closest multiple? So 1 is the first number. First number plus the closest multiple. How much number I need to add, I'll put that number. Then from 2 to n, I'll simply put 2 to n, whatever be the number. Now this is the first solution. What is the second solution? Second solution is very interesting. See, whatever number you get, right? Whatever number you get for 2, in example, you have seen it as 2 and 4. So they might have thought, okay, whatever be the number, let's multiply it. So let's say it will be 2 and 4. So if it is 6, what happens? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You just multiply the index. 3 becomes 6, 4 becomes 8, 5 becomes 10, and 6 becomes 12. So the sum will be 6 into 7 by 2 is 21. 21 plus 21 is 42. So the sum is 42, and 42 mod 6 is 0. But how did we derive at this? This is very interesting. If you see, right, from 1 to 6, what is sum? Sum is always n into n plus 1 divided by 2, right? What people have done is, what we can do is, our goal is, these all will be multiples, right? These all modulus will be 0 and it's less than 1000. Our only goal is, we have to satisfy the third condition. What is the third condition is, the sum of all numbers should be divisible by n. The sum of all numbers should be divisible by n is, this 1 to 6 sum should be modulo n should be 0. So that means n into n plus 1 by 2 modulo n should be 0. So what do we do? This 2, right? You put it on the LHS. So it will be 2 into sum of that 1 to 6 will be n into n plus 1. So what is 2 into 1 sum of 1 to 6? 2 into 21 equal to n into n plus 1. Okay. So since in RHS it is divisible by n, right? N into n plus 1 mod n is always equal to 0. There are no special characters. So we can say that since RHS n into n plus 1 modulo n is divisible by 0, we can also say that this LHS is also divisible by n. Now how will you code it? You can simply write from I equal to 1 to I less than or equal to n. You can simply see out print as 2 into I. That's the answer here. So I hope these two explanations was clear, and if you like the video, please like, and if you have any comments, right, please share in the comment section, like or any queries or something, I'll try my best to answer those. So that's it, guys. See you in the next question. Thank you.